today I'm just going to be speaking in my Pony. I guess it could be Kievian, I don't know, but I'm finding out in all of my excitement of who am I, I am this William the Conqueror now. I have found from lately I'm William the Conqueror in Kievian tongue, probably. I know, it looks funny. I have to take this my wealth sweater off. So now I'm thinking, how could this be that I'm William the Conqueror, and I'm also from the illegitimate of Robert Caen. Now Caen actually here in France has an entire département. They call them these départements. It's the département nord, directement ici. So it's the northern department, and it's Caen, C-A-E-N. And so now I'm in association with a department. Oh my goodness, how exciting. Oh. And then there, Guernons, the name Guernons. And there is a castle that is kind of scary. And it's like not like really a castle. It looks on the photo as if it is like some spook house. Oh my gosh, some of these places are spooky and scary. And this is a reason also, you know, my name is in association with these spooky stones that have been abandoned and derelict. Oh my goodness, yeah, the Guernons. Now the Guernons also they have in conjunction, I believe, 50 manor houses at that particular time were given to Chester, the Earls of Chester. All of this was going on during this William the Conqueror and Normandy invasion moment. But really, there was a build. There were many, many years when they were living here. Maybe like at least four or five generations living here within the particular Normandy-French persuasion. Area, Britannia, Normandy, Vigne, and into this Guernon in Mont Saint Michel area. So it's quite a vast coverage, particularly of this William the Conqueror group. And then back to Rollo. There's a man named Rollo, and Papa is a wife. I know, I'm really nervous about this guy. And why did he have to conquer? I don't know. Maybe it was an order or something. Maybe it was an order. He had to make the conquering. he looks like he was kicked as a child, possibly by a horse or a mule. He doesn't look like it was a normal face. He does look like he has had some kind of damage. So I believe, aside from, oh my gosh, they're all cousins. I mean, you start to get into King Edward III, it just starts looking like for cousin after cousin after cousin, down to Spain, down to over to Hungary. There were just a lot of cousins going on, and it's perhaps that was a reason also for his unfortunate look. The Vaux themselves are quite an interesting particular name, because I know I'm skipping out and I'm running to Scotland all of a sudden, but in Scotland they rechanged their name from Vaux back to Vin. Meaning, and also that is the meaning of vines, the wine vines themselves. So they changed their name back to the wine, back to the origin of their roots, in remembrance that they're French before they're Scottish. So it is very interesting that they're dedicated at that time in the name change to go back to the roots of France. As a dedication, rather than you know, something else. So yeah, that to me is a strong presence of something was going wrong with the Vaux themselves. Perhaps they were being, I don't know, rejected in some manner by that name, with this Divalibus or whatever. Things are going wrong, and I believe it was a reiteration of back again into Vin, the Vannes region of France. But yeah, so Robert de Caen there is the illegitimate, and so there is illegitimate now, and so now I am William the Conqueror blood also. So I have gone there and attacked. I don't even know the reason. I believe there was a fence up there, the 1066 or something, or 1067, and they all went to there to fight, and they were fighting against the Scottish. And so it could be that my name is extremely controversial because I'm on perhaps they think us as traitors, because we are there fighting as this conqueror fellow William, and yet moving on to the other side and claiming ourselves as Scottish. So it could very well be that we have been seen as deceptors, seen as traitors throughout time, and maybe we got our noses snooted on by the Scottish, and that would be a reason to say, hey, you know, you're gonna have to get out, you're gonna have to go. So it could have been one of the reasons. I know there are some that did live there in this particular, it's a barn barrack or something, they live there. Same group, very terribly same group again and again, and because of that, there it goes into again the lineage, the line itself being disrupted into all these inheritable diseases, you know, that are going genetically, and so their propensity of them must be quite higher than ended up in my family. However, I am believing I am already predisposed to, I believe it is a Huntington's disease that is in my line also, and I also have this Debary, and I have the Guillon, which is another. So they have this syndrome named after me, and so it's interesting. So I believe I'm not really sure the actual what it is with those three. But perhaps when they are put into conjunction, they form a new disease, the one that has not been documented. And so this may be something that the doctors might want to be interested into, is that merging of the different genetic inherited diseases from all of these surnames. You know, we're finding all these surnames and putting, you know, pluck and play all of these different ones together. It's very possible that we have made a new one, you know, we make a new one with each, and so like right now I have very much the sleepy leg syndrome. I say leg, but it's my arms also. I feel very much that I am going into a numb state majority of the time, and so I must fight it, I must stand up, I must sing the opera, whether you like it or not, I have to do this, or I just perish into a place where I'm sleeping only. So I have got to move. So it's possible when we're putting these surname inheritors together, this is what it has become. So I'm addressing my brothers also if they are having this problem. That would be perhaps part of our you know, dropping something. If you're dropping. You don't hold things well and they drop, and you are weaker, you are much weaker in fatigue. So I believe that could be, it also happened to my mother also. She became extremely sleep, I'll call her sleep, she just all of a sudden had to sleep like unbelievable amounts. And it's not sleeping, it's literally just lying down. It's not that you have to go to bed sleeping, but no, you just have to lie down. So I don't know what you call it. No, I don't like names of muscular dystrophy or anything like that, because it's not that tremendous, you know, wheelchair inviting. It's nothing like that. However, it is a demand. It is a demand of is the demand of having to attempt to move, otherwise you fall into a place where you cannot move. So it is this fight much of the day. I'm now realizing. So back to the Guernons, and yeah, oh my gosh, it's scary. It's a scary Guernon, isn't it? What was the deal? And at this time in history, they're also, oh my gosh, the travelers, like you can't believe, they're going all the way to Spain. This is before Alfonso. This group particularly was before Alfonso. They were not in marriage with, and yet they were still down there, and they were being granted lands. They were granted a province in Portugal, so I believe Alazumba or something like this, but it starts with an A with a Z. But yeah, they're granted a province in Portugal, and so at this moment, it's just a friendly situation, isn't it? My cousin over there can have the province in Portugal, and this one can have this Caen can have, you know, the illegitimate. We give him that place in the north of France, and this one over here. So it's all been going on, you know, and it's just like, well, my goodness, I don't have the energy to conquer England. I do not have the energy to conquer England. Perhaps what went on in Scotland, there was much, I'm seeing it again and again with the Stuart family and my family and the Kennedys, again and again, Stuart family and my family, again and again, being bred with, I believe, a few others. And yeah, I imagine they were all cousins at some point. And so, I don't know. I think I have one eye moved in closer or something. Just only one. But yes, Kiev, and many times we're in Kiev. When we go from the Mary of Hungary, her mother was the great cumin witch, the greatest cumin witch of all. Well, her particular husbands were getting their women and from Kiev. They're bringing them in, beautiful women from Kiev. So they there they are. My goodness. So I have two women from coming in from Kiev, going into Hungary, with the Zoltan. I'll call him the Arpad dynasty. And my goodness, oh my god, I'm actually really excited about it all. But Zoltan himself, if you look at his statue, he is impregnated into the concrete. He is impregnated into the concrete, below his knees down. And so it is as if somebody wanted him to stay there still in Hungary forever. You know, you cannot travel anymore, you cannot provoke any more wars or territories elsewhere, you must stay there. So it is almost like the ruling parties after, the ruling dynasties after, had made the decision that do not free him from that concrete ever, because he is such a power that he will wake Hungary again and bring the people back into a greater place than where they are now. And so this was exactly my thought, is why they put him at the chump at the knees there. Nothing like cutting him off, you know, no, it is not a funny joke against any short political leaders who want to go walk around him and say, yay, you were matching him in height also. No, it is not any kind of, yes, a lot of political leaders, you are so small and miniature. I am like, what is this? Why are they so small? It is perhaps the way it goes. It's just perhaps the way it goes. Just tiny people. So a funny one. So where am I? I'm back here at the Guernons. I believe it's a Rogion. I'm not sure his full name, but this particular place is just like a pinnacle place, kind of like Mont Saint-Michel in style, that is up there on the hill, and yet it is like, I don't know, are they graffiti palaces now? You know, they become graffiti palaces. So it is quite a disturbance. It's quite a disturbance to go through all of these castles. And my gosh, I think I have 50 now in France already in find. And it's just become ridiculous, you know, with my name and association. And I don't mean to strut it, but at some point, there are so many Americans that I'm associated with that have no want at all ever to be in France. And so this is the problem. So this is my particular line. That means their friends, the other second cousins over there, and the third and the fourth, and all the way through, all of these surnames, same thing applies. So we are here going, well, it's kind of the onus is on us. You know, we are there, the builders. We are the ones that originally the names of. These are our castles, these are our regions, and yet, We have disheritant brothers and sisters who want to stay over there in their particular mannerisms and have no want of anything until it's all fixed and beautiful. And then they can have that wonderful vacation, perhaps. But they're not thinking of the future for their children. They're not thinking of the future for their children at all. That it is right now a time. It is right now a time to take a claim, an absolute claim, back again. You know, new dynasty all over again. And perhaps their minds have become so small and turned off that they cannot fathom it. It is like too tiny a life that they're leading in their head, you know, that they're living on a one thought provoke. You know, you say, one thing, you say, oh, she's a gymnast. And so that's it. That's all they see from this person forever, is that she is a gymnast. They cannot go past. So we're dealing with a small mind that can only put itself into this person is this, and this person is that, and this person is the other. And it just try to free yourselves from those people. Try to free. Those people have been absolutely a grain overload on you. You know what I mean? Try to free yourself from those particular persons. Yo, William the Conqueror. I know I'm supposed to be really happy for it. How did he do it? I imagine they went on boats and everything and oh, Saint Olga of Kiev. Now I'm related to the Saint Olga of Kiev. And so I know somebody's saying, well, don't be so stupid, there's just thousands of you. And then I'm thinking, no, there's not thousands. Because in my particular line down, there's not thousands at all. There are actually very few of us. And so then I'm knowing the same is applying to the others. So I don't know. I'm starting to think maybe, you know, in a million that it should be, that it could be, it is probably more like 2,000. So, yeah. This is the line recent I'm doing that is through the Rocher, and the Samuel and his son David, and those particulars because they're closer, they're more recent, great grandfather recent, as they shoot up to a king line, you know. Because, you know, what are we gonna do when we have this monstrosity of people who are like, oh, that's interesting, we're studying history, we're all excited by history, and we're like, but they don't really have the same, they really don't have the same heart, it's not their kin, it's not their particular, it's a job, you know, and if when it's your family, it is different, that is, those are your stones, that is, those are your particular dresses, the you know, it's a different place in the mind. When it is something that is your belongings, your family belongings, rather than somebody's day job. Now, when it is somebody's day job, take it or leave it. I had a bad time with it. I'm just doing schluppy work as my restoration, you know. It's just schluppy work, you know. Who cares? Who cares? You know, somebody paid me some money to restore something. So I just do it, and I don't know, I get another job tomorrow doing something else, not really liking my boss or something. So that's what's going on. So I'm having like, well, I have to regroup you all, I have to regroup you all and like motivate you and say France is not such an evil place to be, because for some reason it is thought of as an evil place by Americans. And yeah, this particular King Edward III group is American. Because we are the Scottish ones. Majority of us are the Americans. So. I don't know. And there they are, they're Cheshire Dancing Kings. Not the Cheshire cheese. But they do look like they've been eating the cheddar cheese. They are kind of fat, and they've been eating the wrong foods. And so because they are fat, and yet they're dancing, like dancing leprechauns, with the red hair, they're quite humorous. They're quite humorous to look at. And yet, I don't know, they don't look so great in the tights. They don't look so great in the tights. And so what can I say? They were overeaters. They were overeaters. A little bit of fatto. The Earls of Chester. All of those Earls of Chester were a little bit of too fat. And so they may have that particular consumption problem, consumption disease, where they have something here in the, I believe it's something to do with a heartburn, but it is a heartburn that is extremely, extremely quickened. You can just take a few bites and you're dead. So you have to be extremely careful with that type of a heartburn. There's maybe a heartburn that sneaks up on you that you don't know about it until all of a sudden you take that bite and boom, you're done. There was also one that had the association of the fish, the lamprey. And they're saying that somebody poisoned him, but I'm in the belief that he was actually poisoned by the fatty fish itself. It is a river. It's a river eel, and I believe it was a poisoning from the fish itself, from being so fatty. I'm having lots of fun finding out all of these regions and travelers. And one king, one of our French kings, was even born and lived in Le Mans. So that's another humorous. So we're just like fraught with French kings. So that's ridiculous, isn't it? French kings and French, I guess you call them court persons. The French court, the French countesses. But were they really, really, were they really even French? Or just kind of like the Europe house, I'll call them. You know, being in such a conjunction there with Spain, you know, they're marrying here Aquitaine, the Countess of Aquitaine, and over here they're marrying the Count of I guess Stefan with the V, from over there in I believe Navarre, and then Mary of Hungary, you know, so you're having all of these particular inputs, and then there's the Alfonso kings. The Alfonso kings also. Now they're all red-haired. Most of them are some kind of red-haired, light blondish look, and so there it is again. It's like it's not really a Spanish look, is it? It's not really a Spanish look directly. So it's very possible that we are the, I don't know, the upset. The red-haired upsets. I don't know. What was it? William Wallace. There was a wall. They were fighting, and at this wall they're fighting about Scotland. Does Scotland exist? Does Scotland not exist? Is it the lairds, or are they the king, or supporting the King of England? And obviously William the Conqueror was the supporter of King of England, you know, he became the King of England. I'm not even sure if he became the king. But it doesn't matter. He may have been, I'm not even sure if he was the king or not. But that's not even important. It's what's important is, my gosh, he's been such like a relic in all these history shows that it's just like a have to. We all have to know about it, and so much so that I've just turned it off. I haven't even listened. I've just turned it off. I'm like, well, there was a wall and they were fighting, and I'm not even sure why. And then there was the Braveheart guy, and he made the ice skating show. And they were ice skating around, and I watched that maybe, I don't know, 3 or 4 times, and I was getting kind of bored with the music, you know, it was a little too loud, you know, this Braveheart with the famous ice skater of France. That's really all I know of it. But this could very well be that my particular family, all the way down to my mother, my mother's maiden name is a traitor, is an absolute traitor to Scotland, to the original Scottish clans, because we were there mingling. We were there mingling with the French, who were also having their illegitimates, who became William the Conqueror through the de Caen line. Robert de Caen. So it's quite interesting. It's quite interesting, isn't it, that now I am an illegitimately born traitor to Scotland, who cannot eat fatty fish and may have Huntington's disease. So all of this is going on, and yet there is the Stuart family, trotting around with their massive stones of. That's my unicorn, or this is my emblem of wealth, because I have the lions in front of my house, you know. I don't know. It gets pretty ridiculous, you know. it gets kind of funny. So I don't know. I'm just cheering myself up really today. I've been given a 3-week. All these people are. I don't know, they're so clingy over there, you know, like this hub of America, you know, we're clinging to this one person who is my father, clinging to him like he is like, what, you cling to an old man? I'm giving you castles, here, and a chance, you know, I'm giving you castles, list of castles, and you're clinging to an old man who denounces monarchy? That's all you're doing. All you're doing is denying your children any kind of a good life. That's all you're doing. You're becoming him. You're denying any kind of a good life for your children. Now I have beautiful nieces. I have very, very, most likely beautiful young nephews. I haven't even met them all. Now, they have an opportunity in their future here. They have an opportunity to marry into the princes and the princes of Europe. They have an opportunity. I'm here. I have my foot in the door. My goodness, I've been here. I've been here in France 10 years straight, 10, 11, 12 years straight. And then many, 2 or 3 years before this. So what's the deal? What's the deal, you know? We have this castle idea. We have all of these castles very closely in our name, you know, very closely in our name. You know, what is the deal? And I've even said, put the old persons in them. You know, turn them into instead of sending them to these exorbitantly priced, rest homes, where they are people who mistreat them. Put them with the family. Put your 10 or 20 or 30 or 50 of them, in a few of these monster frickin' places, and then the, then there's our business, you know what I mean? There's our business, and that, that makes the money for it. So we have these ideas, and we have this many of them, you know, we and they're mistreated in those places, and you already know it. And so here I have this idea, I'm bringing it out here, and I'm just getting slapped on the face with another email by some parent, wife-in-law, I don't even know what she is anymore, I've denounced her as being married to him, I think it's a foul marriage, I think she is playing games that are hurtful for him. Objectives. You know, only about herself, really. You know, I'm not pleased with her. I expect her to be a coordinator. I don't expect her to be a assassinator of the entire situation. I don't know. Well, What can I say, aside from in the learning of, in the finding out of, I am a masterful genealogist now, and that's where I'm staying. And I believe the Mormon Church needs to open up an organization here in France, a Mormon genealogy outpost, you want to call it. Because there's much information here online, but this new Mormon site online has not been a very good one. It's not been a very good one. It's not easy to find, and there are many repeats, and many that are just thrown in there that are making no sense at all. And yet there are others who have made life histories, and they're right there in front of our face, and yet you have the others that are just throwing out these tangents of nothing, that are not helping. So I believe that in all of their listings, they're having dislistings, and they're not listings trying to rip at the family histories that have already been written, but they are interrupters. They are interrupters into the truth. That's all. They just become interrupters to have all of these extras, you know, because somebody put their name with an S one day, and another day they spelled it with a Sarah, you know. We need to take out the ones that are incomplete, that are incomplete. We need to remove the incompletes, and maybe put them in an incomplete database completely. It's just become an incredible upset. Oh my goodness, so many names. I'm so excited actually with all the French names. I know I mentioned the Ponthiers, which is the chestnuts, but this is not a company grab. This is not a company grab game. However, there is an opportunity if that particular company is like, well, I'm a Ponthier, and there are no more Ponthiers left, and all of a sudden, I'm a Ponthier, and so, well, my goodness, I guess if you want, we can form some kind of a monster monopoly, because there is no way I can run the Ponthier company of chestnuts. By myself, I need these people. I need these people from my family to help and assist. That's all. And so yeah. Yeah. I was going to give a few more. I have a Vermandois. Now the Vermandois, that's one. It just oozes, doesn't it? It just oozes with, oh my gosh, a Vermandois. You know, in all of these, you know, Jean of Valois and all of these, but the Vermandois is just such a beautiful name, isn't it? It's a beautiful name. Some of them are fantastic, fantastic. Yeah. Yeah, and more liabilities we have to send out. That we are not associated with any problems on the properties. Visitors. Gosh dang it, you know, why can't I go back to 2-3 generations and talk to those persons? Because it seems like right now, the persons that are living now are just completely, I don't know, just frippant, like just forget it, you know. There's already a monarchy in England, just forget it. I don't know. I'm feeling like they want to squash me. You know what I mean? And so when you have these types of persons or these types of relatives, you just say, forget it. I have to disassociate with those who want to squash me.